We're continuing our survey in ecology, which is focused on the factors that influence the abundance and distribution of species in space and time. We've already looked at population ecology, which looks at population size within a species, and then we also looked at evolutionary ecology and thinking about evolution of the lifespan. Today we're going to turn to community ecology, which focuses on relations between interacting species. When we look at interactions between species, we want to divide our attention to two different time intervals. First is ecological time, and then also evolutionary time. If we look purely in terms of community ecology, we'll be looking at relationships between different species living in the same habitat. But we'll also be thinking about coevolution, which is joint evolution of two interacting species, so that if one species changes, the other will too. When we're contrasting ecological versus evolutionary questions, first in community ecology, it's still that abundance and distribution. So how does the abundance of one species influence the abundance of another? With coevolution, we're asking, how does evolution in one species influence the evolution of another? There are many possible outcomes of interactions between different species, and we're going to focus on them according to the net result, whether they have a net benefit to each other or they're mutualistic, whether they have a net harm on both species, so it's competition, or if they're one-sided, where one species benefits at the expense of another, in the case of predation or parasitism. So first off, we want to keep in mind we're going to be contrasting impacts in ecological time scale, which is short-term, or evolutionary or long-term consequences of each of these different types of interactions.